So, hello everyone. Around 10 months ago, I was posting a video about taking apart this ASUS GTX1070 Turbo GPU, and that time I was changing a thermopaste, cleaning and changing a thermopaste, but now I need to take that thing apart one more time, and this time the problem is that the fan started to make an unpleasant noises. So what I need to do today is to take that apart again and change the ball bearings on a fan so the GPU can continue mining. So since first part of the video, the disassemble itself is fully covered in my previous video, I will just carry on with taking it apart without comments. If you need detailed instructions, check my previous video. Link is in the description below. So let's carry on. So now we're at the point where we need to actually remove and tighten the screws which are holding the fan. So the fan itself here is held by three screws. One is here, which you can see, but the other two is, well, they are here under the thermal pad. So I would suggest not to unscrew everything straight away completely one by one, but slightly to untighten so you kinda release the fan down. Otherwise, if you unscrew one screw, for example the one here, you're going to break a thermopad. As you can see, I have a hole here already, so don't do the mistake I did. So just one by one you untighten them and let the fan to sink down. You just carefully raise the thermopad here and then start unscrewing that screw there. Here is the same story. Alright, so all the three screws are untightened. I suggest to remove that one away. Then you release the cable and you can lift the cover from a place, leaving the fan on its place down there. So, here's the fan. So, to take apart the fan itself, oh guys, it is a pain. Seriously. ASUS itself did everything to make it as hard as they could, as well as if you manage to take it apart, you have a very good chance to lose the circlip, which actually holds the fan together. So from here, proceed with extreme care. This fan is not like other fans which you put on the GPUs, which you can actually force open. This one is held together by a circlip, which you can find when you turn the fan over. As you can see, I have a hole here already, but originally the sticker here is like, it's covering everything. So what you need to do, you have to cut this part open, and then there underneath you can see the small circlip there, and to take that one out is it is hard. So for that you need something like a circlip pliers, and they actually come in different dimensions. The ones you need for that job are in a size of 3 to 10 millimeters. I didn't manage to find such size, so I took actually a bigger one, and what I did, I took a grinder and made these tips smaller. So with that thing, you should be able to catch that circlip, open it up, and get it off the shaft. All right, let's try to do that. Maybe I'll manage to do it quickly, maybe I'll manage to do it slowly. Oh, that's amazing. Here it is. I think that was the quickest time ever. That's my personal record. So here is it. Here it is. That's this tiny circlip. So now we just open up the fan, take the starter out, and here is one ball bearing on our side, another one. So we just take them out somehow here. Just use a rotor to push them out. Yeah, here is one. And just use something to push our one from our side out. So here we go. So the ball bearings, what you actually need, it is 693ZZ. And the catch here is that the 693 ball bearings, they come in two sizes. Well, first of all, inner diameter is 3 millimeters, outside is 8 millimeters, but the catch is with a width. So 693, it comes with either 3 or 4 millimeters in width. The ones you need is 4. So the size of this ball bearing is 3 millimeters, 8 millimeters, and 4 in width. 693ZZ, 3, 8, 4. So I got the ball bearings from AliExpress. Here we are. It took a while for them to arrive, but finally we got here. So yeah, 3, 8, 4. 693ZZ. Put them in from one and our side. And put the motor back together. Here we go. Alright, so now we need to put this wonderful circlip back onto the shaft there. And so how I did it was so. Here it is. I used a toothpick to put it kind of on a shaft, and then I used a small tube with an inner diameter of 3 millimeters. So I just push it onto the shaft there. So we just go, and once it clicked on, it's there, and you can release the fan. So here you go. Fan is ready. Alright, so now in order to assemble everything back together, first of all we need to mount a fan back onto this inner case with thermal pads. We still have two screws here inside, if, as you can see, the ones which are under the thermal pad. I didn't took it out, not to damage thermal pad even more. So I use slide this cable back into this opening here, and just try to put these screws into their positions in a fan. Put the thing onto the table and just tighten the screws. Fix the cable, and here you go. So now the fan is now in place. Let's put the inner case into the outer housing. And fix it in place with all 7 screws. Again, as I said before, I'm not explaining too much about how to assemble or how to disassemble this GPU, because everything was covered in a previous video. So if you need the detailed description, just follow the link and you'll see the previous video and we folded out detailed information about how to unopen, how many screws and everything. So now, as you can see, I've cleaned the old thermopaste from here. Unfortunately, you cannot take apart this GPU without replacing the thermopaste. So I decided to give my GPU a little treat and got an expensive one, Noctua NT-H1. So let's apply the new thermopaste and assemble the GPU. So here you go, it's done. We changed the ball bearings as well as applied a new thermopaste. Thank you very much for watching, and I really hope that the video was useful.